This is Narayanadi from Narayana Technics. So today's our topic is just an introduction to functions mechanism. So we know that what is meant by function. Function is nothing but set of statements or instructions to be performed a particular task. So we know that C program is nothing but a collection of functions. There should be one function name, it is called as main function. Why? Because always the program execution will be starts from main itself only. So that is the reason every C program should have a collection of functions. There should be one function name is called as main, because always the program execution will be starts from main itself only. So now what is the advantages with the functions? So up to now, whatever we written the program, so whatever we given the set of videos, so that is to be writing the programs using the C language, which is given with only single function mechanism. But now, from now onwards, we are going to talk about to be writing the set of functions mechanism. But what is the advantage with this using functions mechanism? What is the advantage using the functions mechanism? One is called a modularity mechanism. What is mean by modularity? Modularity is nothing but dividing the program into number of blocks mechanism is called as modularity. According to C language, the C program can be divided into number of blocks mechanism as a functions here. So whatever the C program is there, which can be divided into number of blocks as a functions mechanism. Say, let us, for example, if you are developing an employee payroll system. When you are developing an employee payroll system mechanism, where you may be required to be developing, to dividing your application into number of blocks mechanism, that is adding of new employee details, displaying of existing employee details, searching of the employee details, calculating salary of the employee details, or modifying the employee details mechanism, department wise salaries, monthly salaries, annual salaries, so on, so whatever these things. So this set of functionalities are there. You should be divide your each and every task in subtask mechanism as in separator functions mechanism. That is using the functions mechanism. This feature is called as modularity mechanism. Next, another advantage is called reusability. Their only meaning. What is meant by reusability? So whatever the group of statements which are required more number of times, more than one time. So those group of statements will be going to putting into one function. What is meant by function? Set of statements or instructions to be perform a particular task. Whatever the group of statements which are required more number of times, those statements will be going to putting in one function. That function can be used to be called wherever it is required without rewriting the existing function or existing function statements or instructions or statements here. So that is called as reusability mechanism. So that what is the advantage using this concept is you can able to save the time and as well as you can able to save the memory also. So once the function has been defined, this function can be called wherever it is required without rewriting the existing function statements or instructions is called as reusability mechanism here. So the advantage by using this reusability mechanism, whatever the group of statements you are placing in only once, you are not writing more than more times here. So or wherever it is required, so that you can able to save the time and you can able to save the programming space also. That is advantage with the reusability mechanism. Then next one is called as the types of functions here. Generally, the C language is going to supporting the various types of functions mechanism is of two types mechanism. What is the two types of these functions or called as? One is a built-in function mechanism. Another one is called user-defined functions. What is meant by built-in function? Built-in means their only meaning. The functions which are already exist, already defined is called as built-in functions mechanism. Whatever these functions which are already exist, these functions are not required to write by the user. User need not to write any code for this kind of functions is called as built-in functions. So whatever these built-in functions which are already exist in our C language, that function has to be called by the user without rewriting those function statements or instructions. Examples like printf function, scanf function, square root function, power function, whatever these functions are there, which is already exist and already available, this kind of functions. So we'll just use to call in our programming without rewriting those existing function statements or instructions. Next, another type is called as user defined functions. Their only meaning. The functions will be going to defining by the user according to the requirement. So let us, for example, if you want to be calculate factorial value of the some number, or printing the multiplication table of the number, or printing the number in reversing order. So whatever these kind of functionalities are there. So such functionalities are not exist by user defined functions according to the C language. So in this situation, so user should be defined their own functions according to users here. And when you are defining this function, so this function code should be defined by user, and as well as the user can be defined the function name according to the user requirement. That is, user can give any user defined function name with validations, that is called as user any valid function name. Those validations are called as whatever rules you have been followed, that is to declaration of variables, those same things will be followed in the function definition, that is a function name of the user defined function definitions here. So user defined functions are nothing but the functions can be defined by the user according to the requirement, and the function name can be any user defined valid name. But user should be follow, while defining these functions, user should be follow some set of rules to be defining of these functions according to the ANSI standardization, nothing but American National Standard Institute standardization. That is called as, those rules are called as, one is called prototype function declaration, second one is called as function calling mechanism, and next one is called as function definition. So well, the user can define their own functions according to their requirement, and function name also can be defined by the user, any user defined valid name. But while defining these functions, you should be remember that you should follow some set of rules, that is ANSI rules. So while defining these functions, which are called prototype function declaration, function calling mechanism, and as well as function definition, these three rules should be followed by the user while defining these functions. So in the next video, we'll be going to discussing that how to creation of user defined functions, that is by using the prototype function declaration, function calling, and as well as function definitions mechanism, and as well as categories of the functions to creation of user defined functions. So users, if you like this video, please like and share, and for more updated videos, please subscribe our channel. Thank you, one and all.